Sagutan natin tong problems. Let's start with one. How many dinners are possible consisting of soup, dessert, drink, and viand if one can select from 3 soups, 4 desserts, 5 drinks, and 5 viands? So basically, gagamitin natin dito yung fundamental principle of counting. So ano ba yung fundamental principle of counting? So it states that if one activity can be performed in M ways, and if, when it has been done, a second activity can be performed in N ways, and if, when that has been done, a third can be performed in P ways, and so on, then the number of ways in which they can all be performed in the order stated is M times N times P times dot dot dot. So, ibig sabihin, kung meron daw tayong different activities na pwedeng i-perform in different ways, as in for the first activity, M ways, second activity, N ways, third activity, P ways, and so on, yung total number of ways na pwedeng ma-perform yung lahat ng events na yon is the product lang ng number of ways ng iba't ibang events na yon. So, kung i-consider natin yung problem, pwede natin i-consider yung event na pagpili sa soup, dessert, drink, and viand. So, we can draw a blank for the event of choosing the soup, another blank for the event of choosing the dessert, another blank for the event of choosing drink, and lastly, another blank for the event of choosing the viand. So sa soup, meron daw tayong how many choices? We can select 3 soups. Sa sulat nyo dito sa soup is 3 choices. Then for the dessert, meron tayong 4 choices. Sa sulat nyo is 4. And for the drinks, we have 5 choices. So you write 5 under the drink. And finally, we have 5 choices of viand. So we write 5 under the viand. So para makuha natin yung possible combination nitong dinners na consisting ng soup, dessert, drink, at viand, equal lang to sa product nitong mga choices sa soup, dessert, drink, and viand. So therefore, we just need to multiply 3 times 4 times 5 times 5. So if you multiply that, you have 3 times 4 is 12, times 5 is 60, times 5 is 300. So therefore, the total number of possible dinners will be 300. Next for B, a coin is tossed 3 times. What is the total possible outcomes? So this time, magtutoss daw tayo ng coin 3 times. So meron lang tayong isang coin na itutoss daw natin 3 times. So pwede rin natin i-apply dito yung fundamental principle of counting para malaman natin yung total possible outcome. So let's draw a blank for the first toss, another blank for the second toss, and finally, one more blank for the third toss. So sa pagtutoss ng coin, meron lang tayong possible 2 outcomes. So pwedeng heads or pwede rin tails. So therefore, sa first toss natin, meron tayong 2 possible outcomes in tossing the coin. Likewise, for the second toss, dalawa lang din, heads and tail. And finally, for the third toss, also 2 possible outcomes. So by fundamental principle of counting, imumultiply lang natin itong tatlo. So we have 2 times 2 times 2. We have a total of 8 possible outcomes. So pwede nyo actually i-draw yung possible outcomes by drawing a diagram. So you can write first, second, and third toss. So sa first toss, pwede kayong magkaroon ng heads or tail. Then sa second toss, you branch out this head outcome into 2 possible outcome na pwedeng head and tail. Likewise, ito rin tail outcome sa first toss, pwede nyong i-branch out into 2 outcomes sa second toss na head and tail din. Then, for the third toss, i-branch out nyo pa itong second outcome na head into head and tails, itong second outcome na tail as head and tails. Again, i-branch out nyo itong another outcome na head into head and tails. And lastly, itong tail outcome into head and tails. So pag kinuha nyo yung mga possible combination, pwede kayo magsimula sa first, second, and third. So pwedeng head, head, head. Pwedeng head, head, tail. Pwedeng head, tail, head. Head, tail, tail. Next, tapos na kayo sa H, dito naman sa tail, pwedeng tail, head, head. Pwedeng tail, head, tail. Pwedeng tail, tail, head. And finally, pwedeng tail, tail, tail. So, pag binilang natin yung outcomes, dapat 8 ito. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, same lang sa na-compute natin. Next, for 3, how many two-digit number can be formed from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 if A, repetition is allowed, B, repetition not allowed? Okay, so we can also apply here fundamental principle of counting. So, we can have two events. The first is the number of ways of choosing the tens digit. And another event, let's put a blank, this time for the number of ways of choosing the ones digit, since we are required to form two-digit number. So, we can start with the tens digit. So, pagpipilian lang natin is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So, total of 10. Pero, para makonsider na two-digit tayo, hindi pwedeng maging 0 yung tens digit. So, therefore, ang number of choice lang natin sa tens digit should be 1 to 9 or total of 9 choices. So, if you start with A, repetition is allowed, ibig sabihin, pwedeng maulit yung numbers. Pwedeng 11, 22, 33, and so on. So, therefore, pag fill up natin itong ones digit, possible na gamitin na itong numbers from 0 to 9. So, it's a total of 10 digits. So, by fundamental principle of counting, multiply lang natin. 9 times 10, it's 90. So, we have a total of 92 digit numbers that can be formed from 0 to 9 if repetition is allowed. Now, for B, if repetition is not allowed, so, yung tens digit din natin is same lang din, dapat 9, kasi bawal din yung 0. Ang mababago lang is itong ones digit. So, kapag hindi pwedeng maulit yung digit, ibig sabihin, kapag nagamit na natin dito sa tens yung isa, hindi na natin pwedeng magamit sa ones. So, di ba, pwede nating piliin sa ones digit yung 0 to 9 if repetition is allowed. But if repetition is not allowed, ibig sabihin, i-assume natin na nagamit na yung isa sa tens digit, so babawasan na lang natin ng isa itong choices from 0 to 9. So, instead of 10, magiging 9 na lang yung choice natin sa ones. Okay? So, therefore, by fundamental principle of counting, i-multiply lang din natin, 9 times 9, it's 81. Now it's your turn. So try nyo namang sagutan itong questions and just comment your answers.